George July, to Tell the Truth, written and illustrated by Brian S. Walther. Philip Carter and George July were in the yard playing ball. George was the short one while Philip was tall. George tossed the ball to Philip Carter. Philip yelled, "That's not how you do it. You have to throw it harder." Philip said, "Go way back and I'll throw you a long pass." He then whipped the ball super hard and fast. The ball missed his glove and flew over George's head. It smashed into a window instead. Both boys stopped in their tracks. They looked around and what did they see? The broken window of their neighbor, Mr. McVee. It had a huge hole they could see right through. George said to Philip, "What are we going to do?" Philip cried, "I don't know about you, but I'm going to run." George just stood there, completely stunned. That's when Mr. McVee stormed out of the house with the ball in his hand. He asked, "Is this your ball, young man?" George July looked at the ball and quietly said, "No, sir, it's not," as he shook his head. George continued, "It belongs to that Jimmy from across the street." Mr. McVee said, "Do you mean Jimmy Feet?"
"Yes, indeed, sir," said George July. "I saw Jimmy throw it."
George just told a lie. "Well, I'll be," said Mr. McVee. "I will have to talk with his dad, you see." Mr. McVee rushed across the street to talk with Jimmy's dad. He told Mr. Feet that his son was bad. Mr. McVee yelled, "Jimmy broke my window with this ball today. It has to be fixed, and I want you to pay." Jimmy Feet was grounded for 2 whole weeks while George and Philip roamed the streets. After a while, George felt bad. Maybe he should do something like tell Jimmy's dad. When Philip found out what George was about to do, he threatened George and said, "I won't ever play with you." George kept quiet for 2 more days, but a little voice inside said to him, "George, change your ways." George went over to Mr. McVee. He said, "I'm sorry. It was me."
"You're sorry? It was you? Just what did you do?" asked Mr. McVee.
"I broke your window the other day. It wasn't Jimmy," George began to say.
"So what should you do, George?" asked Mr. McVee.
And George said, "Go across the street to tell the truth to Mr. Feet."
George went across the street to talk with Mr. Feet.
"I'm sorry, sir, I lied about your son. I broke the window. I was the one."
Mr. Feet breathed out with a sigh. "I know you did, because I saw you break the window and I heard you tell that lie." George was surprised and asked right away,
"Why didn't you say anything that day?"
Mr. Feet said, "I wanted to see how long it would take for you to tell the truth and correct your mistake."
"I'm so sorry that I lied. What can I do to fix this?" George cried.
Mr. Feet replied, "You can pay for the window by doing chores. You can mow my grass and paint my doors." So George worked all week long completing the chores, mowing grass and painting doors. When he was done, he asked Jimmy Feet to play. He said he was sorry, and now they are best friends to this day. The end.